it didn't make any effort to get any change out or anything. And I always offer. I even offered him when we was in the fucking pub and he said no. And then I said to him I had some change and he said, oh, right. Didn't expect it.
Well, Paul, you don't do it again. I keep telling you, if you say I'll pay, you'll have the expensive stuff on the menu. If you shut your mouth and then at the end of it say I'll pay when you know for what he's got.
No, he said
to.
He didn't want anything and then fucking...
Well, you should have said, too late now, mate.
He didn't even offer the fucking coffee. I said, if you grab a seat, and I fucking paid for it, there was no sign of...
Well, all you've got to say is, you owe me for the coffee, because I'm going to... And tell him he owes me for that Chinese.
When yesterday, like, when we was at the Fairmile, I said to him, I said, well, and he said something, and I said, well, it's lucky Mum gave you back that 20 to pay for it.
Well, I could have kept it, Paul, he wouldn't have known no fucking difference. And he said, after I told him, when he thought about it, oh, I thought I'd put that somewhere else. I thought I might have done. In other words, he thought he might have done and give it to me, but he hasn't. He didn't. He had no idea.
You don't want to stop, do you? Because I don't. Not going to give me any enough fucking room to do anything. See, that's fucking like clutch judder.
It's having your feelings when you go there. See if you can speak to Dave.
What? What are you on about? Not really interested in thinking about it, just the fucking car just don't feel right. Talking to anyone at Slough or Citroen, they don't do nothing, they don't do it fucking properly.
Well, take it back to Citroen West.